Good morning, New Zealand. Today is 10/3/2017. Date in New Zealand is 10/4/2017. In front of me, you can see I have a new map of Google Earth. And we're just going to go down the quakes that have happened since yesterday and into this morning. We're going to start with a 3.0. And I'm using the new Google Earth today, so we're going to do something different. So we can see the area it hit off land. Just give you all a different glimpse and view of this area. It's very beautiful. The next quake was a 1.7. You can see the quake happened over in here. This is Mount Waikambi. The next quake was a 1.8. And this was off land, off the end of the North Island. The next quake was also a 1.8. This is back over here at the Seddon area. Cook Strait. The next quake was a 1.9 at 105 kilometers in depth. This one is next to Mount Tihei. And that's Tongariro National Park. The next quake was a 2.1, and that's down here at the end of the North Island, and that's the Tikiti Seventh-day Adventist Church. The next quake was a 1.9. It was 70 kilometers in depth. And that was off the end of the North Island as well. Next quake was a 2.6. It was 50 kilometers deep. And it's next to the Clarence River. This being the Clarence River over here. The next quake was a 2.5. And that's near the Waitotara River. The next quake was a 2.4. And that's near the Tukituki River. And I'm hoping I'm pronouncing these correctly. See, those look like sheep or cattle. Next quake was a 2.2. This is also down here at the end of the North Island. Check that out. Next quake was a 1.5. This is back down here at the Sedden area. This is Clifford Bay. Then we have right here Lake Grasmere. And this is a salt mine. Next quake was a 2.1. This is out here. Also in Clifford Bay area, and this is Cook Strait here. Next quake was a 1.9, and this is also in the Cook Strait area. Next quake was a 3.1. This is off the end of the North Island. You can see Te Kahe there. This is Bay of Plenty, and that's White Island right there. The next quake was a 2.1. It was 64 kilometers deep and sits right next to a geothermal plant and Aritia Fault. Now if we look right over here, this is Natamariki Power Plant. I think I pronounced that correctly. You can see this is the power plant that sits over here next to it. And it's, if I'm correct, it's geothermal. It's a geothermal power station commissioned in 2013 and operated by Mercury Energy. It is located approximately 17 kilometers northeast Taupo. And if you want to read more about it, you can go on to the new Google Earth and it'll show you. But if you look, this thing is huge. Where we can get a road view? Let's see. Maybe. Nope. No road view there. You can see how big it is. The next quake was a 2.4. This was over here off the end of the North Island as well. Next quake was a 2.8. This was off the tip of the east coast of the North Island. You can see this is Hicks Bay right here. The next quake was a 2.3, and this was offland. That's Tologa Bay and Cook's Cove Walkway. The next quake was a 1.2, not a biggie. The next quake was a 2.0. That's near Oro River. The next quake was a 2.2. I'm not sure why the blue came on. And that's Portland Island there. Napier's here. So we had quake out there. We had 3.2. That Grasmere is here, so we've got a 3.0 and 3.2 here. Next quake was a 2.0. The next quake was a 2.0. And this was off land as well. So South Taranaki Bight area. Next quake was a 1.7. We're just going to go over these. 1.8 followed by a 2.8 at 85 kilometers in depth. You can see these look like power poles. So you have the lines are running through here. This is the Matuka River. This is Kikawa. You see, it looks like a power station here. So we'll go over here and see if that's what this is. If we can land in somewhere here. But don't see a landing. So it kind of looks like another power station or electric company. I am not good at landing. Let's go back up. Let's try this again. There we go. We'll go to the entrance. We'll see. It's Kikuma as service project. Construction site. Interesting. So, I'm not quite sure what that is. It says it's a service project. Siemens. Okay. So anyway, there's a quake within that area. Next quake is a 2.6, 78 kilometers in depth. This was off land as well. You can see White Island is here, so it's over here. Next quake was a 1.7, and that was followed by a 2.7. And that is off of Hawke's Bay, but not within Hawke's Bay area. The next quake was a 3.0. And this was back down here near Sedna area, in the Cook Strait area. Okay, and now, well, we have a 2.2, that's 105 kilometers depth. It looks like these are areas where they're doing deforestation, maybe. Or paths. But anyway, this is the Wangapika River. Now we're going to go and start for the fourth. If we can get to it. Here we go. Okay, we're going to start the fourth. We start with a 1.9. This is off the end of the North Island, and we have White Island right here. And then we have a 1.9. 71 kilometers in depth, which is over here off the North Island. Next quake was a 1.8. This is back over here on the other side of Seton and Lake Grasmere. Let's see what this is. It's a lake, so we'll see if there's a road. Nope, no road. Next quake is a 2.2. Now this is near Breaker Hawk Community. And this is Tarakina Bay. And I think we can land over here. Okay. I'm live. Sorry, you guys. My son is in here talking to me. Anyway, the earthquake was right over in here. We have some gorgeous photography here. From the Google Earth. This is Moa Point Road. Okay, and back up we go. Our next quake is a 2.3. And this is also over here off of Lake Grasmere. Next quake was a 2.0. nuts. Mount Manacle. Next quake was a 2.2. And this is also over here off the end of the North Island. The next quake was a 1.5, and it was followed by a 2.5 that was 72 kilometers in depth. And that's Rotohana. The next quake was at 1.9. This was back over here. Here, Tangil. And this is Hawke's Bay area. The next quake was a 2.5. This is near Kapiti Island. Check out these steep banks. Go around one more time. The next quake was a 0.8, not a biggie, but it was back here. In between Mount Narungaho, and this is Lake Taupo. That's the Alpine Crossing over here. The next quake was a 0.6. The next quake was at 3.9, and it was 81 kilometers in depth. And that's the Rangitiki River. Okay, you guys, and that ends my update for today. Check in with Dutch Sense this evening. And as usual, if there's anything big, I'll jump on later. Much love, you guys, and I will talk to you later. Oh, and by the way, please subscribe. And if you like what I do on my channel, please consider donating to help this channel grow. Thank you.